you've worked on historical projects before. Is that what attracted you to this script?
No, I was attracted to it really because I thought it was such an extraordinary story. I mean, you've got a guy with a stammer, which is dramatic enough if you're a stammerer, but what you wouldn't have in most stories about a person with a stammer is that that person is forced to become King of England against his will, right at the moment when radio has arrived as a mass medium, and so one of the duties is to speak live on this new medium, and you've got the Second World War coming, so that this king has to become a leader at war. And who knew that the guy who saved him was this wonderful maverick Australian speech therapist, a failed Shakespearean actor, not even a doctor. And it's that combination that's so extraordinary, and the excitement of the fact that no one knows the story of Lionel Logue. I mean, we only discovered the diaries that he kept of his relationship 9 weeks before the shoot. It's never therefore been written about properly by any historian, so it is literally a new story that no one knew.
And what was it about Colin that made him perfect?
King George VI, from what I understand, is a nice man to his core, a tremendous humble man, is a gentleman, and Colin is also nice to his core. I mean, there doesn't seem to be a malign bone in Colin Firth's body. But most importantly, I think there's something lovable about Colin, and you know, to sit through a movie with a man struggling with that stammer, if you didn't love him, would be hard. But because you fall for Colin in this film, it makes it, you know, so electrically tense and poignant. And he has this gift that he draws people to care for him in this way.
The story feels really modern, sort of the royal family in the media. Do you think that will help it find an even bigger audience?
I think there's similarities between the 1930s and now. I mean, you know, they were coming out of a Great Depression, as we are also coming out of an economic depression. They face the threat of the Second World War. We face a variety of asymmetric threats to our peace and security. They're both uncertain times, and the way I filmed it, I wanted to make it quite modern and quite direct, so that people related to this character, to Colin's character, as a human being first and as a royal second.